my name is Neil and I'm an instructor here at the Fort Wayne Children's Zoo. Now today we're going to be talking about one of my absolute favorite things, eating, right? Every living thing has to eat. So today we're going to be diving a little bit deeper into what it looks like for living things to eat. All right, now to get us started, I want to talk about three words that you may or may not have heard before. As you look at this board here, you see three words on it. Our top word says carnivore. Now think to yourself, do you know what a carnivore is, what a carnivore eats? You're probably right. A carnivore eats meat, right? There are hunters. The next word says herbivore. Now, herb may be a word that you've seen before. If you think about cooking in your kitchen, you may use herbs in your recipes. Herbs are made of plants. Herbivores eat plants. There are plant eaters, right? Some people might think vegetarians or vegans. Those are gonna be called herbivores today. And finally, we've got omnivore. So omnivore is a very special one. Can you think to yourself, do you know what an omnivore might eat? An omnivore eats both. So they eat meat and plants. So you may be pretty familiar with a type of animal that is an omnivore. So what we're going to be doing today is we are going to be going into each of these three things. We're going to be going through some examples of some animals that we may find here in the zoo or in our very own backyards. We're going to be talking about some different ways that we can help to identify what types of foods an animal may eat based on their teeth. So humans are what we call omnivores, and that means that they eat meat and they eat plants, so a little bit of both. Luckily for us, we have tools at our disposal that help us to eat the things that we eat, right? Now, I'm not talking about a fork or a knife. I'm talking about our teeth. So today we are going to be learning a little bit about what an animal's teeth tell us about what it eats. So the first type of tooth that we're going to talk about is our front teeth, or something called an incisor. So let's learn a little bit more about incisors. So as we think about our incisors or our front teeth, our incisors work kind of like these clippers. These clippers might be used in your yard to clip grass or hedges. Our incisors work kind of the same, right? If you think about you're eating a bite of an apple, your incisors are going to be that first thing that you're going to use to take that bite. So you're going to be cutting that apple with your front teeth. So incisors were kind of like these clippers. The next one that we're going to be learning about is we're going to be moving a little bit behind in our mouths to our canine teeth. So the next type of tooth that we're learning about is our canines, right? Those are our long, sharp teeth that we have. So our canines work kind of like this knife. So this knife is used for stabbing or piercing things. Well, our canine teeth are used in a very similar way. So when you think of animals who might eat meat, a lot of times they're gonna have big canine teeth that are gonna help them to do that. We eat meat, so luckily we have canine teeth to help us. Now, as we move further back in our mouth, the next type of tooth that we're going to get to is our premolar. Let's learn a little bit more about what our premolars are used to help us with. So the next type of tooth that we're gonna talk about is the one that comes next behind our canine teeth. So these scissors are used for cutting, right? We probably use them in arts and crafts, or we might use them in the kitchen, but scissors cut. Well, luckily for us, we have premolars that help us cut the food that we eat as well. So behind our canine teeth, we have premolars. And as we're chewing food, those premolars are helping us to break down that food and cut it up so that we're then able to swallow it. So let's move on to our last type of tooth. So our last type of tooth is our molar. Our molars are teeth that are wide and flat. Do you guys know what this is? This is something called a mortar and pestle. And a mortar and pestle is used to grind things. That gives you a big hint as to what we use our molars for. So our molars are those wide teeth in the back, and those molars are used to grind the food that we're eating down into small pieces so that we're able to swallow it and digest it. So now that we've learned a little bit about the teeth that we have, let's explore teeth a little bit more and try to find out what different animals have in their mouths, which help them to eat the food that they need to eat to survive. So our first animal that we're gonna learn a little bit more about is something you've probably heard of before. When you look at these big teeth, it's gonna tell you something. It's got those big incisors, right? As you look at those incisors, you might notice some things about it. First off, they're brown, and second off, they are really, really long, right? Well, this animal needs those long incisors because what it eats are big pieces of trees. This is actually a beaver. So a beaver just like this has a skull that looks just like this. So as you think about this beaver, it's going to be chomping at those trees so that it can cut them down and use them for their beaver dams. Now, in the back, you may notice that it also has some molars. So beavers eat plants. They are herbivores. And those molars help it to then be able to grind down that food that it needs to eat. So just by looking at the skull, we have a few hints as to what this animal eats. We can tell that it needs to eat big things. It's got those big incisors in the front, and we can tell that it has to be able to grind that food down, and that's what it uses those flat molars for. Let's move on to another animal with a skull that just looks a little bit different. Our next skull that we're gonna learn a little bit about probably looks pretty similar to our own. In fact, this is another primate species. So this is a siamang skull, which is the largest species of gibbon that exists on Earth. So if you come to the zoo and you see our Javan gibbons, you're seeing a species of gibbon just like the siamang. So as we look at our siamang skull, we see that it's got incisors in the front. It's got canine teeth right behind, right? There are those long canine teeth. And in the back, if we look at its mouth, we can see that it's got those premolars and those molars. Now, does this sound familiar to you guys at all? It should, because gibbons and siamangs are omnivores. So their skull looks a lot like ours, and it actually behaves a lot like ours as well. So they're gonna eat a very similar diet to what humans eat. So they eat kind of like we do. Our last type of skull that we're gonna look at is just a little bit bigger. So when we look at this skull, we've got some incisors in the front, so those are gonna help it to cut into some types of food. And we notice this one has some big canine teeth, right? It's got those big long canine teeth. So these canine teeth are going to be used to pierce the food that they eat. Now as we look at our premolars and molars on this one, we notice that they are all pointy, right? They're sharp. So this gives us a big hint as to the type of food that this animal is eating. This animal is a sea lion. And sea lions, if you know anything about them, then you know that their main diet consists of fish. So sea lions are carnivores. They are hunters and they hunt for their food. They use all of their different types of teeth in order to help them to do that. So every animal that we can think of is part of what we call a food chain. So the food chain exists because animals have to get food from something else. They have to eat something else in order to survive. And this is where the food chain comes in. So in a food chain, we can find an herbivore, we can find carnivores, and we can find omnivores. Every living thing is part of a food chain. Now in food chains, we can also find predators, and we can find prey. Think about what a predator is, or if you've heard that word before. Some words that might come into mind are carnivores, or maybe omnivores, or hunters, right? Predators are hunters. So they're the animals that have to hunt something else in order to survive. What does prey sound like to you? Prey should remind you of animals that are eaten, right? So a lot of times we find that insects are prey, or herbivores can be prey to a lot of different animals. But sometimes, even predators can be prey. We're gonna meet a very interesting animal today, and we're gonna talk a little bit about, is it a predator or is it a prey? I brought with me today a very cool animal. This is an African bullfrog, also known as a pixie frog. Now, African bullfrogs, like Charlie here, can grow to be the size of a dinner plate. So they can be very, very large. And in order for them to grow that much, that means they've got to eat a lot. So when you think about Charlie, our African bullfrog, what types of food do you think that he may eat? If you're thinking about flies and insects like that, then you are exactly right. Here at the zoo, Charlie, our bullfrog, can eat up to 20 crickets a day. For a bullfrog, that's a lot of crickets. Now, those crickets will help it to grow. So as it grows, it's gonna get bigger and bigger, and then it will be able to eat other food, things like fish, maybe even some small birds. Now, when we think about Charlie, that means that Charlie is a predator, right? He hunts for some food. But is that all that he is? No. Charlie can also be a prey item. So a lot of bird species, or even some snakes or larger bullfrogs, might take a bite out of Charlie to get their meal that way. So Charlie can be a predator, but he can also be a prey. Every animal has to eat. It's one of my favorite things to do, and it's probably one of your favorite things to do as well. I hope today you learned a little bit about what we can learn by looking at the teeth of different animals that we encounter. Now, we encounter animals almost every single day. The next time that you encounter an animal, think about its teeth and how you can learn about what they eat from those teeth. Thank you so much and enjoy the rest of your day.